What's going on, classic fans? Skunk Monkey again with another video for you. I'm going to try something a little different this time. This is going to be the first installment of my very first series on this channel, one I'm going to call Zone Spotlight. Now, it's no secret that many of the zones from vanilla WoW are either no longer accessible in some way, or so radically different from the original states that it's virtually like stepping into a new zone. In this series, I'd like to take a few minutes to remember many of the original vanilla zones that have been lost to time. I'll try my best to be totally unbiased in this series, but for my first episode, the Horde blood coursing through my veins coaxes me to focus my first episode on my favorite zone in classic WoW, the Barrens. Nestled in the middle of the western continent of Kalimdor lies the Barrens, a sprawling, sun-parched savanna that's known for its harshly arid climate and its immense size. In the days of vanilla, the Barrens was the biggest zone in the game. In fact, a normal player at walking speed, it takes over 15 minutes to journey across the zone from end to end, a fact that's either endearing or nauseating, depending on who you ask. At its northern end, mob levels begin at 10 and increase 15 levels by the time you reach the southern tip. This enormous level gap, combined with the enormity of the zone itself, caused the Barrens to be a mainstay for beginner Horde players of all races, wetting their feet and cutting their teeth with the massive amount of content and adventure the zone holds. It wasn't always like this, though. Not many players are aware, but before the end of the War of the Ancients, the entire world of Azeroth was one massive, Pangaea-like supercontinent. The Barrens we knew in vanilla was actually a landlocked haven for Kaldori Night Elves. A lush, vibrant forest, brimming with abundant flora and teeming with wildlife. To put it in perspective, the area we now know as the Barrens looked much more like its now neighbor to the north, Ashenvale. Densely wooded forests dotted with bustling Kaldori settlements, but an ancient evil was waiting, eager to devour the world of Azeroth, hungry for her magics. The highborn Night Elves, under the direction of Queen Ashara and her counselor Xavius, began to perform increasingly powerful experiments in the Well of Eternity, Azeroth's source of magical power. The turbulent arcane energies cascaded outwards into the great dark beyond, rousing the interest of beings bent only on destruction. Sargeras, drawn to the power of the well, sought to bring his million-strong army of the Burning Legion to destroy Azeroth. He lusted for the energy of the well, eager to claim its power as his own. Queen Ashara, driven mad by the well's power, fell victim to Sargeras' demands. Intoxicated by arcane energies, she transformed the Well of Eternity into a gateway for the Burning Legion. Wave after wave of demonic abominations poured forth from the well, laying waste to everything in their path, leaving only ash in their wake. The Legion made short work of any resistance, and all looked to be lost. However, a rebel force, led by Malfurion Stormrage, sought to stop the Burning Legion. Malfurion knew that the well had become an ethereal tether for Sargeras' forces, and thus had to be destroyed. The battle between Malfurion and Ashara threw the already unstable energies of the well into even greater chaos. The rift created in the well, crippled by its own turbulent magic, imploded in on itself, collapsing the foundation of the temple and sundering the earth in all directions. This was henceforth known as the Great Sundering. As the Well of Eternity consumed itself and the landscape around it, it caused a massive explosion that blasted apart 80% of the continent. As the dust settled, what was left was the western continent of Kalimdor, the eastern kingdoms, and the residual chaotic energies of the well, forever spinning into eternity, known today simply as the Maelstrom. The lush vegetation and teeming wildlife that had been burned from the face of the Barrens, leaving the sun-scorched savanna we know today. The harsh climate, while hostile, did little to stop the forces of the Horde from claiming it as their own. Despite the ever-present Centaur warbands and Quillbore invasions, the Barrens became a stronghold of the Horde and its allies, and any fledgling adventurers sought to make a name for themselves in this vast landscape. Well there, bet you weren't ready for that history lesson, were you? The rich history of this area is only a small part of why I love this zone so much. The zone of the Barrens itself is a shining example of masterful zone design in MMORPG. The next logical step for Tauren, Trolls, and Orcs after their starting areas, the Barrens is a place where many Horde players, like me, fell in love with the game. Jesus, even half the time when I made an undead character, I'd usually end up over there too. It quickly became a rite of passage, and a milestone in Horde leveling. It was just so perfect. To the northeast you have Orgrimmar, the bastion of the Horde. To the north, the tranquility of Ashenvale. Stone Talon Mountains lies to the northwest, with the Tauren homeland of Mulgore to the southwest. Thousand Needles to the south, and Dustwall and Marsh to the southeast. One zone, bordered by a dense forest, mountainous crags, stretching grasslands, rolling plains, twisting canyons, and fetid swamps. The amount of choice given to players here is second to none, and the tantalizing question of, where should I go next, lingers in the back of every player's mind as they travel through the zone. Because of its centralized location and its tendency to funnel in players from the starting areas, the Barrens quickly becomes one of the most populated zones in the game. The Crossroads, the settlement players first encounter, becomes the first real gathering place for players outside of capital cities. Being a centralized hub, the Crossroad gives direct flight path access to nearly every Horde outpost on Kalimdor. It truly was a hotbed of activity in vanilla. It's not uncommon to see players learning their classes and testing their skills in duels in a large open area in front of the inn. The sheer amount of quests obtained here is another draw for players as well, including several of the more meme-worthy ones, like the task of obtaining the infamous Zephyrhooves or learning the harrowing fate of Mancric's poor wife. To the southeast of the Crossroads lies the neutrally aligned goblin port of Ratchet. Here players can access a bank, a flight path, and can also board the faction-neutral boat and make a trip to Booty Bay, another notable hub that lies on the southern tip of the Eastern Kingdoms. Many lessons were learned here by new players. Being faction-neutral, Ratchet was the first area that new players encountered members of the rival faction. Anyone who felt the need to display their dominance were swiftly greeted by the bruisers of the Steamwoodle Cartel, a harsh first lesson for many. Having a neutral flight path as well as a neutral cross-continental transit system meant the port of Ratchet was a destination for players across the entire game, low-level and max-level players alike. The torn settlement of Camp Tarajo is another relic lost to time, and the final settlement Horde players will encounter as they progress through the Barrens. During the Cataclysm, this unassuming village was burnt to the ground by the Alliance, leaving only charred remains in the retail version of the game. Led by Jorn Skyseer, Camp Tarajo is a perfect example of a small but expertly crafted quest hub, with bare-bones amenities and a multitude of quests available to brave travelers. It was the next step for players after working through the quest of the Crossroads, and quickly became another milestone in the Barrens leveling experience. Containing some difficult and higher-level quests, players knew that they were but a few steps away from choosing their next zone. Not only did the Barrens have some of the most amazing quest hubs in the vanilla World of Warcraft, it also contained some of the most notable dungeons as well. Wyndling Caverns was the first real dungeon Horde players to encounter, as its difficulty and length were a stark contrast to the more tutorial-style instance of Ragefire Chasm. A level 15 to 20 dungeon, its deep, winding caverns succeeded in confusing and disorienting many players, who were thrown off by its numerous elevation changes, switchbacks, shortcuts, and dead ends. A handy little tip, if you travel westward at the entrance, double back around and climb the mountain, you can actually walk on top of the instance entrance, with some tactful rock jumping and a little parkour. Players can discover a secret cave that houses two quest givers. Bits of flavor and discovery like this only add to the allure of this dungeon. In fact, if you back far enough away and look at the entrance from afar, you'll see the cave looks like a giant skull, with a quest giver's hiding in the left eye socket.
They're real brutal. This is a real brutal place.
Razorfen Crawl is a level 30 to 35 dungeon that lies on the western side of the Southern Gold Road. A Quillbore fortress, players will be tasked with trudging through thorny outcrops and ramshackle mud huts, battling all manner of squealing Quillbore along the way. With notable drops, including the Corpse Maker, Deathspeaker's Robes, and what will very well be the first helmet for warriors, the Tuscan Helm, RFK will be a tantalizing dungeon for many players. The Barrens' third and final instance is Razorfen Downs. A level 40 to 45 dungeon, RFD is unique and is the only dungeon in the Barrens where players will have to travel back to after they progress through the zone. Because of this, RFD offers an interesting and introspective look at the player's past experiences in the game. Landing in Camp T, a place you've long since outgrown, summoning your mountain and traveling the road like many times before, offers player a chance to reminisce about the zone they previously spent so much time in. It gives the player a tangible sense of the power they've gained, something that's at the core of the MMO experience. The dungeon itself is another example of fantastic level design. With it being the ritualistic burial site of the Quillbore, it's since been overrun by the Scourge. The ethereal power flows through the dungeon, reanimating fallen Quillbore into shambling abominations. The dungeon itself ends with a harrowing climb up the winding spiral of death, fending off forces of the Scourge as you ascend to the pinnacle. Once at the top, you're tasked with taking down a Memnar the Coldbringer, Hand of the Lich King, and the final boss of the instance. RFD is also a place that sees many of the game's first plate drops, including a helm and chest, making it a mandatory stop for warriors of all specs. You also get to square off against this guy. I mean, look at him. Fuck yeah. If bustling quest hubs, dozens of quests, and three dungeon portals wasn't enough for you, there's also an entrance through a battleground. The entrance to Warsong Gulch lies just west of the Morshan Ramparts in Northern Barrens. While essentially made obsolete with the introduction of Battlemasters in patch 1.6, it's so cool to see an early relic from the time when Battlegrounds were first introduced. Now I know what some of you may be thinking, and you're right. I've neglected to talk about something that I'm sure is on a lot of people's minds as they watch this video. While the Barrens is so memorable for a variety of reasons I've already covered, there's one other thing that makes it so memorable. That's right, baby. Barrens Chat. I'd be willing to bet that Barrens Chat was the first meme ever to arise from WoW. With the popularity of the zone, the immense level range, the attraction for low-level and high-level players, there's never a shortage of people in the Barrens. When you combine the zone's dense population with a huge amount of travel time and downtime between quests, you have a recipe for chatbot shenanigans that is yet to be paralleled by any other chat channel in the game. While questions about quests and gameplay were frequent, discussions broke out that rapidly devolved into unabashed absurdity, cementing it in the annals of meme history for ages to come. Barrens Chat thus became the birthplace of another notable WoW meme, one that doesn't need any introduction. Nobody knows where it started, or how it came to be, but Barrens Chat lofted Chuck Norris into demigod status, seemingly overnight. You couldn't look at the chat for 30 seconds without seeing a corny Chuck Norris joke or a Chuck Norris-related fact that somehow wove its way into WoW lore. Chuck Norris is the real war chief. Chuck Norris doesn't do push-ups, he pushes Azeroth down. The gates of Ankaraj only open because of a well-placed roundhouse kick by Chuck Norris. The Chuck Norris theme chat was so prevalent that it drove many to the brink of madness, with cries of, "Can't you guys make your own Chuck Norris channel?" Of course, that only fanned the flames. Besides, you ever seen what happens when you try to slash join Chuck Norris? As you can probably tell, the history behind the Barrens is lengthy, momentous, and oftentimes downright hilarious. It's no secret that hundreds of thousands, if not millions of players have experienced its numerous adventures, embedding it as a location in the game that will be remembered forever. While the current retail version has drastically changed the landscape of the Barrens, the legacy it's created in the game is a timeless monument to days past. I, for one, am beyond excited to be able to experience all these things again during the launch of Classic, and I know there's countless others who feel the same. I eagerly await the time where I can again join my Horde brothers and sisters in one of the most iconic zones ever to exist in World of Warcraft. There you have it, guys. The Barrens holds a special place in my heart, and I can't help but smile as I make this video. I have so many fond memories of this place that even just hearing the music brings all those feelings flooding back. Does the Barrens have this effect on you guys? I would imagine from my Alliance friends that there's a zone that mirrors the wonderment and intrigue that the Barrens creates for Horde players. Do you guys have a favorite? Let me know. Drop a comment. If there's one that sticks out, I'd love to tackle it in my next Zone Spotlight video. As always, I want to thank all of you for watching. If you liked it, leave me a comment, drop a like, and subscribe. I've got much more planned for the future, so stick around. I'm just getting started. Once again, guys, I am Skunk Monkey, and I'll catch all you Classic fans on the next one. Peace.
Fucking Chuck Norris.